हाय फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज हरीश गोपाल है। वेलकम टू द चैनल टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ लैब ओवर एंड ऑटोमेशन। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट इज इवेंट स्ट्रक्चर एंड हाउ टू यूज इन द लैब ओवर प्रोग्रामिंग। बट बिफोर गोइंग टू लैब ओवर विंडो फॉर प्रोग्रामिंग, लेट्स गेट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी विल यूज इवेंट स्ट्रक्चर। वी नो दैट व्हेन वी नीड अ कैलकुलेशन, वी ऑलवेज यूज calculator software in our mobile or in our laptop. Okay, and simply first we put the first number, okay, and then after that we put any arithmetic operation, like right now I'm putting multiply, and then we put a second number. Okay, but if you see, we could not get answer directly after putting the numbers until we not press the equal button. Okay, after pressing the equal button, we will get the answer. And guys, this is the standard rule. Okay, we always follow these rules. That's the another thing that our advanced calculator software gives us the disable answer before pressing the equal button. So exactly we can do same work by using event structure in LabVIEW. That means event structure waits until an event occurs, then execute the appropriate case to handle the event. Okay, now again, the event structure means it has one or more subdiagrams or events cases, exactly one of which executes when the structure executes to handle an event. This structure can time out while waiting for notification of an event. Wire value to the timeout terminal at the top of the left of the event structure to specify the number of milliseconds the event structure waits for a event. Okay guys, if you do not understand by simple theory, don't worry about it. Let's move towards the LabVIEW window and click on this blank VI. And then press Ctrl and T. Now go to the block diagram window and click here on event structure. Okay, you can see guys, this is the event selector label. This selector label specifies which cause the currently displayed case to execute. For example, if supposed we want to execute case of addition, so for that first I need to create a button to handle this case of addition. So simply create a button. For that, right click, go to the control palette and then click on this OK button. Okay, change the name, that is addition, addition. Okay, change the name, that is addition, add. Okay, it is enough. Select this, make it size large. Okay, now how to add this addition case in this event structure. Okay, for that, before going to add the case in this event structure, change the position of this addition. Now how to add this addition in this event structure, addition case. So for that, right click and go to, and click on this add event case. Yeah, okay, and you can see the addition. So this is the event source, means what, this is event handler. Okay, what is event handler, as already I have told you. Okay, and this is event means value change. This means we'll get a different value after running this program. Okay, now click on this OK. Yeah, so you can see the current case of addition of this event structure. Okay, now we know for addition we need two controller and one indicator in the language of LabVIEW. So simply right click and go to the numeric palette and click on this numeric control. Okay, change the name, that is X. Okay, and then copy this, control C, again paste here, and again paste here. change this third controller into indicator because we need one indicator to get the result. Okay, change to the indicator and change the name. That is what output. So simply write output. Okay, now come to the block diagram window and change the position of both controller and indicators. Okay, now simply use addition tool to add the number. Go to addition and yeah, put capture and then connect X terminal to the first controller, connect Y terminal to the second controller and connect output to the indicator. Okay, yeah, that's great. Now put this addition tool into the addition case of this event structure. Okay, and then click on this run button simply. Okay, yeah, now guys, you can see it is continuously running. Why? Because it is waiting for event, and our event is the addition button. Okay, as I already told you in the theory part, when I will press on this addition button, then only the code will stop the execution. So for that, first we need to change the values from the controllers, both of the controllers. Okay, 16 plus 16, that is 32. When I will click on this addition button, then I will get the answer. Okay, you can see now, right click. Yeah, I'm getting 32 answer. Now guys, also we can add multiple cases by using multiple events. Okay, like addition, for example, similar like addition, we can create event for other arithmetic operations like multiplication, divide or subtraction. So now how we can do this? So for that, simply first change the position of both controllers and put this controller outside the event structure. Okay, and then change the shape of this event structure because I want free space to put the while loop, sorry, to put this event structure into the while loop. Okay, now right click and go to the structure palette and click on this while loop and put this event structure into the while loop. Now guys, why I have put this event structure into the while loop, I think I don't need to explain you why, because I already taught you. Now first create a condition, that is a control. Create control, yeah, now this is our condition. Yeah, now come to the blocked front panel window and change the position of this stop button. Okay guys, now simply similar like addition event, we should create other events for now other arithmetic operation like for multiplication, I need to create multiplication event. So simply copy this and paste here, control V, again paste here, control V, again paste here, control V. Okay, and then change the name, that is what, multiplication, MULTIPLM multiplication, CATION, simply. And this is what, subtraction, so write sub because it takes so much time to write. Okay, and this what, divide, so write divide. Okay, divide, and then okay, change the name, that is mul, multiplication means what, mul, subtracts, that is sub, and this is what, divide, so write divide, divide. Okay, divide. Now increase the size horizontally so it can visible to us in a better way. Okay. Yeah. Now select this output and make its size large. So, and similarly select all the controllers and make its size large so that it can be visible to us. Okay. Now change the position. Yeah. Now we have all the events. So simply again go to the event structure, right click, and then because of notification, yeah, now add event case, and now the second case of event structure is multiplication. So right click on multiplication and click on this OK button. Now again simply put the multiplication tool, where is that? Yeah, okay, and then connect X terminal to the X controller, Y terminal to the X2 controller, and output terminal to the indicator. Change the name of second controller, that is Y, simply. That's great. Okay, again right click, click on this add event case. Okay, simply remove here. Okay, and now for subtraction, this is the event. Okay, and click again for subtraction. Just keep subtraction tool. Yeah, this is subtraction tool. Okay, now connect X controller to the first controller, connect Y to the second controller, and connect output to the indicator. Okay, simply, and then again right click, go to the add event case, and then simply create event for divide lastly. Okay, simply go to the numeric palette and click on this divide. Yeah, finally we have all the cases, and simply connect X terminal to the X controller, Y terminal to the Y controller, and output to the indicator. Yeah, now we have all the cases of this event structure. Okay, now simply put this divide into the divide case. Okay, now come to this subtraction case and click on this once again, click on the subtraction. Okay, yeah, so this is subtraction. So first change the position. Okay, now come to this subtraction case and put here. Okay, and then where is the multiplication? Double click, sorry guys, huh? Double click, yeah, I'm getting. Change the position simply. Now go to the multiplication case and then put here. Okay, I think I have mentioned all the positions. Okay, addition tool, multiplication, yes, then subtraction, yes, and then divide, yes. Okay, now click on this run button. Now again if I'm clicking on this addition, then 16 plus 16, that is 32. I'm clicking multiplication, then you can see 16 multiplied by 16, that is 256. Subtraction, that is 0, and divide, that means what? 1. Okay, if suppose I will try to stop the program by pressing on the stop button, then it will not stop. You can see it not stop. Why? Because I have put stop button outside the case structure. In this, and this stop button is one type of event for the event structure, because I am using event structure right now. So guys, remember one thing, that whenever you use event structure come to this event structure and right click and click on this add event. One minute guys, add event case. Okay, and then click on this stop button, and then click on this OK button, and then put this stop button into the event structure. Okay, and simply connect one controller to the indicator. Okay, if you not connect, then it okay, and then again click on this run button, and then change the value of one controller and then see changes. Addition 17 plus 16, 32, 33. Multiplication 272. Subtraction 1 and divide, that is 1.62 whatever. And then click on this stop button. So we have successfully run the program, and this is what event structure. And I think I have explained most of the things about event structure, that what exactly is it and how to use in our programming. And in my further videos, I will explain many examples based on event structure. So I think it is enough for this session. Thank you so much, guys. If you really like my videos, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and press bell icon for notification.